As the 12th century hit Japan, feuds between different temples were still commonplace and became a tool used by samurai to co-opt their strength into their armies. On a large scale, this was done by the war that defined the age, the Genpei War between the Taira and Minamoto. For example, Taira no Kiyomori lavished gifts of rice and silk to Enryakuji near Kyoto as a preemptive move to stop them from joining the Minamoto, as the Minamoto already had the support of the monks at Miidera. And the prowess of the Sohei is well documented in several cases, but at the Battle of Uji in 1180, it became legend with monks such as Gojin no Tajima, Susui Jomyo Meishu, and Ichirai Hoshi, remembered to this day. The battle goes that a force of Minamoto samurai and monks from Miidera had to defend a bridge and a temple behind it from a Taira attack. Reinforcements were delayed by a monk from Miidera with Taira sympathies. The monks pulled up the planks of the bridge to stop the Taira cavalry from crossing and used any weapon available to hold their position, but were ultimately defeated, and the death of Minamoto no Yorimasa in this battle would set the standard for harakiri for the future age. Retribution followed and Miidera and many temples in Nara were burnt to the ground. And 3 years after that, when Emperor Go Shirakawa was kidnapped by the Minamoto, he was defended by monks from Mount Hiei. The next big event of the Sohei was when Emperor Go Daigo was given sanctuary by the Sohei of Mount Hiei and even launched a brief rebellion against the Kamakura shogunate. Shortly after, the Ashikaga took control of the shogunate and favored Zen over other Buddhist teachings, leading to discontent of the Tendai sect temples especially. Now moving on to the Ikko Ikki movement, loosely translated as Devoted League or Single-Minded Riots. Its roots would start around the time when the teachings of Rennyo of the Jodo Shinshu sect of Buddhism started to take root. Rennyo could be said to be the only unifying presence in the movement early on. Due to his extreme ideas, Rennyo was forced to flee Kyoto and establish Yoshizaki Gobo in Echizen province. It was at this temple that he gained a significant following among peasants and farmers, the idea of Ikko Ikki being two ideas merging into one. Ikko referring to the one-mindedness sect of Nenbutsu, which taught salvation by faith, and Ikki being the leagues formed by Jizai samurai or small landowners to come together to defend their landholdings and interests. There were many Ikki rebellions against the Ashikaga, and in time to come, peasants became more active in the movement and many Ikki members occupied monasteries and shrines to ring bells to scare the rich citizens nearby. Thus, the movement turned from one of landowners to a broader group and also became more organized. In fact, this led to a violent uprising when a more organized Ikko Ikki overthrew the governor of Kaga province and ruled it by themselves. The first time in Japanese history that a group of commoners ruled a province. A less interesting note on Rennyo being that he was a pacifist and never supported any armed conflict, but he was a practical man and did have his temples fortified and agreed to self-defense in this age of constant strife. So that is the rise of militant religion that led to the Ikko Ikki. How would this progress for the Sohei and the Ikko Ikki? Find out next time. Until next word.